the last 3 years, I restored a Broadwood square piano from 8020. It took me about 1200 hours, but I think it's worth it. I was convinced that when I restored every part, this would be the only way to be sure that the sound comes as close as possible to the sound of that time.
Ik ben zelf altijd heel erg verwonderd en ontroerd over de klankschoonheid van de oude instrumenten. Omdat iedere toets zijn eigen karakter heeft, elk register heeft zijn eigen karakter. En de verschillen zijn heel groot, hè? Tussen een bas, een tenorregister en een heel korte toon in de diskant die een heel klein harpachtig tingeltje is en dan eigenlijk al voorbij.
And this piano said something about the music in that time. This instrument shows how normal people had music in their living rooms. And I think that's a forgotten story, and that's reasonable because there are almost no complete fully restored square pianos.
Zo'n tafelpiano is een stille getuige. En hij is een hoorbare getuige zodra hij erop gaat spelen.
For me, it's very inspiring to play this instrument, and it's nice to see that the historical part of that century, of that period, is brought to life again when it's been restored. And it's very nice to see square pianos restored nowadays. But I think it's a very intimate and very passionate instrument also, because it brings out the most deep feelings sometimes.
My purpose is to show this restored instrument to everybody by means of recordings, small concerts and presentations. As you can see behind me, a restoration costs a lot of time. But when it's finished and played by the greatest pianist, Olga Pashenko, and recorded in the Steppenwolf studio by amazing sound engineer and pianist Slava Poprokin, it feels like traveling back in time. Magic.